Now, if you talk about the remote management, so that option, which is the third domain of the console connectivity, and I really like this option because it's directly related with the server maintenance, management, and operation. So, as you see on the screen, that section is known as firmware and operating system software. So, you know that whenever we talk about the hardware components, Ethernet adapters, storage controllers, then NVMe controllers, so all these controllers are generally controlled by softwares, which are generally known as drivers of all these components. So sometime when we are going to set up a new server from scratch, so in this case, we need to download the latest version of all the service packs, all the firmwares, all the drivers from the HPE support side. And then we import all those components over here. So here you can see if I logged into the support.hp.com, so there are a number of options available regarding the network adapters, regarding the service packs, regarding the controllers, and all other stuff. So if I want to download any option from here, so I just need to search as per my own requirement, download that specific component, go through the web URL setup, and here you can see update the firmware. But before updating that firmware, I need to upload to the ILO repository. So here you can see, I will need to choose that file. And here, from this section, if I downloaded that specific server pack or any firmware, so I will just need to select that file, upload it, and after the upload process, I will definitely go and upgrade the firmware. And here you can see, I have number of 1.6 TB NVMe storage drives available. So their drivers must be updated, up to date, and all other components, which here you can see. Here I have the storage controllers, both storage controllers. One is allocated for or reserved for the second volume for the virtual machine infrastructure, while the first one is completely dedicated for operating system volume as well. So I need to update all the drivers, all the firmwares, all the softwares regarding all these components just to make this hardware more performance oriented, more secure, and more compatible with the operating system as well. So that domain is really, really important if you are working as a system engineer, if you are a tech support guy or technical support consultant. So you must have to know about each and every component, update those components, and you need to select the right firmware from the HP website. So this option regarding the implementation of the server, regarding the troubleshooting, regarding the operations is really, really important. And after this, we will definitely explore the next option regarding the remote connectivity of the HPE server.